Namaskaram. So let's discuss diversion of income and application of income. So to understand distinguish between two, you need to go through a lot of case laws to technically understand difference. But as academic, so far as academics are concerned, it is easy to understand. First, I'm trying to explain you what is application of income. Okay. So application of income can be easily understand by this example. Okay. So you are the assessee, okay, and you prayed to one particular temple, okay, you went to a temple and you said, God please, okay, give me the rank in this particular attempt. After joining the job, my first salary I will donate it to you, okay, this is what you have told to particular temple. And after getting the first salary, okay, when you get about to get the first salary, you directly told your employer, sir, please do not give the salary to me, because if you give the salary to me, I may spend that money, I may utilize that money for my own selfish purpose. I had promised one particular temple or trust. You please donate this salary directly to the temple. And in that year, you had received only 11 salaries, because one salary, 11 month salary you received, and 1 month salary was donated to particular trust. So the question arises, on how many months salary you will pay tax, on 11 month salary or on 12 month salary? So assess, you argued with the department, because I received only 11 month salary, I should be paying tax only on 11 month salary. Whereas the department said, no, this 1 month salary you had already earned. You had right over that particular salary. You could have done anything with that money. You decided to donate that money, and therefore it was money earned by you. You are supposed to pay tax on 12 month salary. So this is one of the simplest example of application of income. One more example if I have to give you. Every month you are an assessee. After married, okay, there is a spouse. This is your spouse. Your spouse, you had, you know, mutual understanding, whatever money you will earn, say for example you are earning 1 lakh rupees, your spouse is asking 30% from that, so 30,000 rupees you are giving to your spouse every month for having household expenses, for maintaining household expenses. So can you argue with government that I will be paying tax only on 70,000 and on 30,000 you take tax from spouse? So answer is no, because where to use that money is your call. You had earned this 1 lakh rupees, so you are supposed to pay tax on that 1 lakh rupees. This 30,000 is an application of income, which is the taxable in the hands of the assessee. So application of income, very important, you need to remember here is this, application of income is the taxable in the hands of the assessee. Now let's come to diversion of income, okay. So what is diversion of income? So diversion of income is, diversion of income is something which is under obligation, okay. First of all, it is happening under obligation. This obligation is created by deed or by law, okay. This is created by deed or law, and this is well established that before income reaches to the assessee, before income reaches to the assessee, it will be divided, okay. One of the example that I would like to give you here is this. There is a partnership firm, okay, partnership firm of Dilip, Anjesh and Ram, okay, Dilip, Anjesh and Ram, and now Dilip is getting retirement from the firm. Now the condition on which he is trying to get retirement, please understand, he is ready to take a retirement from the firm. He is saying, okay, I'll retire the firm only on one condition, and I'll allow balance partner to continue the firm only on one condition, that you have to insert into partnership deed that after my retirement, every year you will be paying 30% income to Mrs. Dilip, okay. So 30% income we have to pay to Mrs. Dilip. This is the condition written in our retirement deed. And we, like balance two partners, got agreed to it. Now you can understand, this is an obligation created by deed. In future, if that partnership firm earns 100 lakh rupees, out of 100 lakh rupees, as agreed by them, firm will keep only 70 lakh rupees, and they have to give to Mrs. Dilip 30 lakh rupees. Now, this is the condition of a law created by the deed, and therefore this 30 lakh rupees is a diversion of income which should not become taxable in the hands of firm. Firm is liable to pay tax only on 70 lakh rupees, and therefore you need to remember here again, under the diversion of income, this 30 lakh rupees is not taxable. Okay, so let's have understanding from theoretical provision. What is application of income? Okay, application of income means discharge of an obligation which is gratuitous, okay, which is self-imposed after reaches. So this after word is important, this self-imposed word is important. After income reaches to the assessee, and hence it is taxable in the law. Whereas the diversion of income, you can understand here, okay, diversion of income is by virtue of an obligation, okay. Income is diverted before it reaches to the assessee, known as the diversion of income, and it is not taxable. Sometime the assessee is the one who will collect the income and then pass it on. Here also the firm has collected this 100 lakh rupees and then it will pass it on 30 lakh rupees to one of the partner's wife. Look at the example, easy example given by institute here. A, B, C are the co-authors of the book. So obviously whatever royalty comes will be divided equally among them. Okay, the publisher of the book gave the whole royalty of 6 lakh rupees only to Mr. A. Now, Mr. A is the one who went to the publisher and collected that 6 lakh rupees. But that doesn't mean 6 lakh rupees is an income of Mr. A. It has to be divided between among Mr. A, Mr. B and Mr. C equally. So, A paid 2 lakh rupees to B and C each. Now, such payment is a diversion of income. It's not an application of income, and therefore, Mr. A is not supposed to pay tax on 6 lakh, but he is supposed to pay tax only on 2 lakh. B will pay tax on 2 lakh and C will also pay tax on 2 lakh. So this is what you need to understand academically for diversion of income and application of income. As and when we move forward in chapters also, we are going to encounter certain case laws which are based on the theory of diversion of income and application of income. This is an end of our chapter number 1, which is basic concept. I request all of you to give us feedback about the lectures. If you need certain modification, please suggest us those in our comment box, because after chapter number 2 onwards, we can change our strategies according to requirement of the student. We must use this lockdown period to the best of our preparation, because we all are stuck in our houses. And we don't have to do anything else. Now the time, this time you have to utilize exclusively on your preparation. And for students who are appearing for professional exam, this is a golden opportunity, because exams are getting postponed and they are getting this extraordinarily extra time that other students in previous attempt and in future may not enjoy this opportunity. So please use this opportunity to the fullest. Suggest us, notify us if you are having queries. Please write down it to us, shoot it in a comment box, and please acknowledge the efforts by liking and sharing our channel. Please, thank you.